Aging is one of the few topics out there that's relevant to every single one of us. It's relevant to you, it's relevant to me, and it particularly happens to be relevant if you're studying a PhD, as you can see from my aging process here into this grumpy looking guy at the bottom of your slide. The World Health Organization have released projections showing that global life expectancy has been steadily increasing for the last several decades. And while this is certainly something to celebrate, as it represents advancements in medical research and improvements in a healthy lifestyle awareness, it also presents several challenges. As we age, our bodily functions tend to become less efficient. For example, we tend to experience cardiovascular dysfunction, and this is a result of our arteries becoming stiffer and more rigid over time. As a result, our heart has to beat more vigorously and more frequently in order to transport blood around the body to where it needs to go. This puts us at increased risk of heart failure. We also tend to experience a process called sarcopenia, and this is where our skeletal muscle begins to break down and waste away over time. As a result, we lose our physical strength, we tend to lose our mobility, and we become more reliant on other individuals and on society in general to live our day-to-day lives. So what can we do to help try and combat the negative consequences of aging? Well, the first thing we can do is to increase the amount of physical activity in our day-to-day lives. However, an even simpler strategy that we can try is to modify our diet. And our research specifically proposes that by increasing the amount of omega-3 polyunsaturated fatty acids in our diet, we can help combat some of the negative consequences of aging. Omega-3 polyunsaturated fatty acids are essential nutrients. This means that they are required in the diet. They cannot be physically synthesized within the body. We mostly find them within fish and in certain types of vegetables, and the European Union have recommended that we should be having at least 1 gram of omega-3 polyunsaturated fatty acids in a week. Our research has taken adults from Dundee over the age of 50 years old and supplemented them with high dosages of omega-3 fatty acids for a period of 6 months. In this time, we found that older adults taking these supplements have a lower resting systolic blood pressure, indicating that they're more protected from cardiovascular disease. We've also found that during exercise or submaximal exercise, they have a better cardiac output, meaning that they're pumping more blood around the body during this exercise, suggesting that more blood is getting to the active skeletal muscle. We've also found that at rest, there's a better perfusion of oxygen into resting skeletal muscle. So now that we've established that omega-3 fatty acids have protective effects on older adults, all we need to do is figure out how to make them taste a little bit more like chocolate, and we should have a healthier, older population any day now. Thank you very much.